نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها صدق الله العظيم. I just recited the first two verses of Surah E Zilzal. Surah E Zilzal is a surah in the Quran which talks about some of the major Muslim beliefs. First of all, the surah lays emphasis on the end of the world. It is one of the very important Islamic beliefs that this world is temporary and a day will come when all the landmarks of the earth will be overthrown and the world will be blown away. And that day will be the final day, and that day is given different names in the Holy Quran. The Holy Quran called it Al-Qari'ah. It is also known as Al-Haqqah, and usually we call it Al-Qiyamah. And the description of the day is given in many parts of the Holy Quran. This surah also says that the earth will be shaken to its utmost convulsion and the earth will throw out all of her burden. The earthquake will come to the earth is mentioned in other parts of the Holy Quran, like Surah Al-Hajj says in verse number 1, Ya ayyuha an-nasu ittaqoo rabbakum inna zalzalata as-sa'ati shay'un 'azeem. O mankind, fear your Lord. Indeed, the earthquake of the hour is a terrible thing. Angel Israfil alayhi salam is right now having the trumpet in his hand and he is waiting for the permission of Allah, and when he will blow the trumpet, the entire system of this universe will be overthrown. And the best description of that day is given in Surah At-Takwir in the Quran, where Allah says, إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوْفِرَتْ, when the sun will be covered, وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ انْكَدَرَتْ, when the stars will be falling down, وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ سُيِّرَتْ, when the mountains will be floating in the air, وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ, and when the oceans will be filled with fire. Similarly, there is another surah which tells us about the destruction of this world, that is Surah Al-Qari'ah. Verse number 1 of Surah Al-Qari'ah, from verse number 1 till 5, is a description of that day where Allah says, Al-Qari'ah, the calamity. Ma Al-Qari'ah? What is the calamity? وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْقَارِعَةِ, and what will tell you what the calamity is? يَوْمَ يَكُونُ النَّاسُ كَالْفَرَاشِ الْمَبْثُوثِ, that day mankind will be like scattered moths. وَتَكُونُ الْجِبَالُ كَالْعِهْنِ الْمَنْفُوشِ, and the mountains will be like carded wool. Even the scientists have accepted the fact that this world is temporary and a point will come when the entire system of this universe will be overthrown. They say that due to the gravity, everything is attracted by earth towards it, but day will come, a point will come when the gravity will be reversed and then the earth will throw out everything in it, and that thing is predicted in the Holy Quran over here. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا, the earth will throw out all of her burdens. There are hundreds of thousands of facts in the Holy Quran which prove that Quran is really the book of Allah, because the things which are mentioned in the Holy Quran 1400 years ago, the science is accepting all those facts today by doing the latest scientific research. This surah also tells us about the limitless powers of Allah, because Allah is the only one who is maintaining the entire universe right now. The entire system is run only by Allah alone. And Allah is so powerful that when He will decide to destroy it, He can destroy it with a single command. He will just give the signal to Israfil alayhi salam, He will blow the trumpet and the system will be overthrown. It tells us about the limitless powers of Allah. Allah's powers are also made very clear in the surah, because the surah says, يَوْمَ إِذٍ تُحَدِّسُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا, the earth will disclose all the deeds of mankind. Because Allah will give this ability to the earth, so Allah is all powerful. He can make anything speak about the deeds of mankind. Earth right now is witnessing all the things of every human being. Whatever we do in our life, we are doing it on earth, and earth is witnessing everything. So all the things are going in the record of the earth, and on the command of Allah, the earth will start disclosing all the deeds of the people, that what deeds were done by every individual on it. So it tells us about Allah's powers. There is another place in the Holy Quran where Allah says that even the human body will also speak about the deeds of mankind. Like Surah Yasin, chapter number 36, verse number 65, which says that الْيَوْمَ نَخْتِمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. That today the mouth of that person will be sealed, and the hands will speak, and the legs of the person will speak about his deeds. So there is no way that a person can escape the consequences of his deeds. Allah will make the things speak about his deeds. It can be the earth, it can be the parts of the human body. So we should remember that nothing will remain hidden from the records of Allah, and a day is going to come where we have to face the consequences of our deeds. In the end of the surah, Allah is saying that فَمَنْ يَعْمِلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرٍ يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمِلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرٍ يَرَهُ. That whoever will do an atom's weight of good shall see it, and whoever will do an atom's weight of evil shall see it. It is also telling us about one of the major Muslim beliefs, that every good and bad deed we are doing in our life is going in record. And it is also recorded by Kiram and Katibin, which are appointed on our shoulders, and they are recording our good deeds and bad deeds. And their record is so comprehensive that when this record will be given to the people on the judgment day, they will be amazed by the comprehensiveness of this record, and they will say, as it is mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf, they will say, وَقَالُوا مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا. What kind of book is it? It doesn't leave even a minor thing or a major thing. So all the deeds we are doing here will come in front of us, and we have to face the consequences, whether the thing is small or big. Why Allah is mentioning over here that even the slightest thing will be in record? Because sometimes we think that small good deeds and small bad deeds cannot affect our life, which is a big mistake. Because if a person will continue doing a small good deed, so slowly and gradually, by the end of his life, he will have a huge amount of good deeds which will help him in the next world. And if he will continue doing the small sins, considering that they are very small and they cannot affect in our second life, so it will be a big mistake. Because if he will continue the small sins continuously throughout your life, so by the end of your life, it will be a huge amount of bad deeds, which will become a big problem for you. So the surah is telling us that we should not underestimate the small things, the small good deeds and the small bad deeds, because even a single thing can affect our life in the next world. There will be cases on the judgment day when the people will be in need of only one good deed, and but they will not have the opportunity to get that good deed in the next world. So we should not underestimate the small things. It happens in our worldly life also, that sometime in examinations we need only one mark to get passed, we get only one mark to get the highest in the class, but that one mark is not given to us by the teacher. So the same case can happen on the judgment day, that a person is in need of only one small good deed, or he thinks that if I had not done even one small sin, so that could be better for me, but there will be no benefit of regretting on that day. This surah talks about the reward and punishment, which is a repeated theme of the Holy Quran. This theme is also mentioned in Surah Al-Qari'ah, where Allah says, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ. And those whose balance of good deeds will be heavy, they will be in the life of bliss. وَمَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَهُوَ أُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ. And those who will have the bad deeds heavier than the good deeds, their abode will be Haviya, and that is the bottomless pit. There are many things we can learn from this surah. First of all, the surah reminds us that this world is temporary. Our stay is too short over here, and our final abode is Akhirah. So we should focus more on Akhirah in our life, instead of spending our life remaining engrossed in the worldly activities all the time. So if a person will waste all the energies, all the hours of his life and all the years of his life in just running after this world, so obviously he will be regretting about this act in the next world. Ulama say that right now we are sleeping, but when we will die, we will wake up. Because when the reality will come in front of us, then we will realize that we had to do something else in the worldly life. And we wasted all the time running after the worldly things, and the world will be destroyed, finally. And the world will be destroyed on its time, but our life is too short. Once a person came to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and asked him, when Qiyamah will occur? So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, Mamata faqat qamat qiyamatuhu, the person who has passed away, his qiyamah has occurred already for him. So the day when we will die, that will be our qiyamah. So we should realize that the time we are given in this life, we have to spend that time in the preparation of akhirah. That is the most important message of this surah. The surah at the same time is also developing the fear of Allah in our heart, because when we think that even the earth is witnessing our deeds, even the body parts are also witnessing our deeds, so it develops the fear of Allah, that when we will be standing in front of God and Allah will be checking the record of our deeds and we will not be able to hide anything, so obviously it will be a very tough time for us. So it is better for us that we should avoid sinful activities and spend our life in doing the maximum good deeds. And why Allah is mentioning over here that even the smallest good deed, even a good deed which is equal to mustard seed, will be taken into consideration? Because Allah is not going to count the deeds. Allah will not count the deeds, but Allah is going to weigh the deeds. Whenever in the Holy Quran, Allah is talking about the reward and punishment, He talks about the balance, it talks about mizan. Allah will put the good deeds and the bad deeds into the balance, and Allah will check the weight. And the weight will depend on our intentions. The judgment will not take place in a way that if a person used to offer five times in a day and he used to do a lot of umrahs and hajj, he used to do a lot of charity, so Allah will say to him that you should directly go to Jannah. No, but Allah will ask him to put your deeds into the balance, and the balance will show the weight, and the weight will depend on the intentions. If the intentions will be pure, the smallest good deed can be very heavy in the balance. And if you have done a big good deed, but the intentions behind it is just to show off, so obviously that will become weightless in the balance on the judgment day. So one of the very important message of this surah is that we should do good deeds, and the intentions behind it must be pure, otherwise it will be useless on the judgment day. May Allah give us the opportunity to follow the teachings of this surah in our life, and make this surah our guidance in this life so that we can achieve success in the next world. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Allahu, 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 Allahu.